Okay.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nancy Ames, and tonight we are going to be learning how to paint the nighttime cherry blossoms as seen in this image right here. Before we begin, though, I'd like to tell you a little bit about myself. I am a native to the Augusta area. My father retired here in 1990. I attended Harlem High School, where I was a student in the National Art Honor Society. I did drawing and painting, a little bit of photography. However, I'm not your traditional artist in the fact that I do not hold an arts degree. However, I still love to draw, paint, and take lots of photos. So this evening, let's start with this picture. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask me as we go along. The first thing we're going to need for the cherry blossom photos, we're going to need some black, white, and if you don't quite have red, we can still use pink, or which is right here. I have Diva Pink and Spice Berry. I'm going to actually use both colors to kind of get the light and dark in together, but if we had red, I would use just regular red and show you how to mix that. And then I have Award Blue. Award Blue is a really cute little color. It's an in between light and dark blue, and we're going to get exactly what you see here. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get my 3¼-inch brush. It's one of my favorite brushes. I use it all the time. And we're going to start out by blacking in our corners. And you can just kind of, however you want, you're going to start to make a circle as we go into the inside. But the corners you want black, because this is a nighttime photo. Right? So you can go big or small, whatever you like. Feel free to, as I show this part, to pour yourself a beverage if you don't already have one. I myself have my beverage here. And once we're done with the black, which I'm going to move out a little further, you notice I have little streaks in my painting. You may not be able to see them up close. But then we're going to go into, I'm using a paper plate because it's a little easier than my palette at the moment. I'm going to mix my blue and black together a little bit. So I've got some streaks in there, and that's kind of what you want. We're going to go through and make a C. We're going to do the other side same way. Make that C backwards. Right? It's looking a lot more black than blue, so we'll add more blue to the brush. And I like to go usually from the bottom up, but let's go this way because of the colors I have on the brush. See how I've got that blue squeezing right on in there on top of that black, and how they're starting to blend. There's no right or wrong way to blend these colors. So keep going around, make your C. And as you go out, you're going to fill in those little dark spots, right? Lightening up your picture. Now the bottom, you don't focus so much on the blue in the bottom because we're going to cover it up with black later. I'm going to do my other side, same thing. Start at the top because I have the most blue on my brush. Go around making that backward C. We want to get that oval going. Right? Drag that wet black paint that you still have right on in there. And it's okay if you're running out of paint and you have, you know, blade spots in your canvas. We'll just fill that in. You'll have stripes in your paint. You'll have your blacks and blues together there. Just fill it in. Okay? And I kind of do a C and go around. Nothing has to be perfect in art. Art is our interpretation and of how we see the world. So there is no right or wrong when you make your picture. If you need a break, take another sip of your beverage. Just kind of have fun swirling those colors. When my brush is a little dry, I'm going to add a little water. And now what that does is I can go back, thin my paint a little, mix it some more, add some more blue. I'm going to go right back around where I was, making that circle. My circle's a little crooked. Yours might be too. Maybe it's the wine. Maybe it's You know, perfect circles are difficult, so no big deal. There it is. I started one earlier today and actually had my canvas in the other direction, and you're going to end up with an end product that looks like this. But actually, that was my bottom, but I liked it better, so I think it'll be the top. And we'll add that and save it for another day. So once we're right here, I need to get a little lighter with the blues. I'm going to pull up that same picture that's right here in my cherry blossom tree. I'm going to pull it up on my phone because I have better colors from a more detailed image. I did that one in about 10 minutes, maybe the other day. So this one's a little more in depth is what I'm looking for. So my brighter blue is going to come right around. Some white to that blue, right? Because it is too dark. And that's what we want a light, basically baby blue. And it's gonna go here. Making my C's, my little circles, swirl it around. Actually want that real light color that I have going on right here on the side, close to the bottom of the tree. So just mix some more dark in there. My black, because my corner, there we go. Get that in there. And this white right here, don't worry about it. We're gonna cover it up with black. Swirl it around. So we have pretty even circles. A little more light blue in there. Yep. Looks like I still have some black going on my brush. No wrong, no right way to do it. If you finish before I do, feel free to take a sip. But I like going over it several times. So that way get a nice thick layer going on. Alright, we want some of that white. White. And I have actually mixed all of my white into blue. So no worries. We can always get more paint. White. Coming into our circle. My circle a little too small up there on the top where I needed the white because of our moon. That's okay. I'm going to dip in my water now and add that wash. What this will do is it'll blend your paint and it'll also help you smooth out these lines that you've made. I'm going to take my half-inch brush, same circle movement. I'm going to add some little spots in here, some polka dots. That's going to be my shading under the tree. Right now, it's just kind of lumpy bumpy, and that's okay. Add a little more water. Too dark. Clean the brush out a little more. White. kind of just padding the canvas, making little, almost looks like waves. Just stipple that on there. Some more white. Because I really want the middle of my canvas to be white. Circle pattern. You see how it blends right on in there? That's what we want. Alright, now that I've finished this part, grab my 3/4 inch brush one more time. And we're going to go into the black and do our ground. I use the flat end of the brush. I'm going to go straight across. We're basically going to make our hill. So it's going to look a little however you want. And I have a little hill started there. Everything under the hill is going to be black. Hill is really light. Let's add some more black. Put back in here. Here we have our hill for our tree. You have to dip in water and just kind of gives it that smooth look when you're done. My canvas is dry. It's not as black as I wanted it. So look down here. Soak my brush in its little water bath so that way it can be clean for the next use. Now I'm going to use my 1/2 inch brush. And we're going to start our tree. So I'm going to dip that right in the black. And if you look, you can see the roots down there. Mine are a little thick in the picture. The one I'm looking at, the roots are smaller. We'll just do a little skinny line for our tree root. Oh, mine's too thick. I may have to go with a smaller brush. Yeah, I don't like this brush, so I'm going to go skinnier. we're just going to make almost like a question mark, like that. Just a swervy line. This is going to be our where the start of our tree is, the swervy line here. I don't really have any paint on my brush, so it's kind of making it easier to drag these little lines and erase some paint. That's little details for the roots. Your tree needs branches. Go. So now you have your question mark, right? On your question mark on this side, we're turning into a Y. Look at that. And branches, little sticks. Just kind of tap them in there. And just have little dash lines in the sky. Not really attached to each other, they're not really doing anything, they're just there. Right? Got another one here, coming straight down. Just kind of lightly lift up as they're fading off into the sky there. Get them smaller as you go down. Barely touch the canvas. Lines going. See, we push down a little too hard and we have extra branches there. Basically making little V's, little lines. This one's kind of an X. And just kind of holding there. You know, you go too thick, that's okay. Drag it out with a brush, just a little bit like that. There's no mistakes in art. When you're painting, you can always cover it back up if you don't like it. Add a little more black. You're just going to have a random branch right there. No flowers. Branch up there. Branch. Pieces. And then kind of follow the shape of my sky in the background. The fun part going to be the blossoms. They're so easy. They're just little dots that you're going to do. And I have my Diva Pink and a little bit of that berry color. I'm just going to swirl them together to get, you know, a reddish pink color. And have it as bright or as dark as you want it. And we're going to make, follow the C around. So we're going to do polka dots all the way around. Oh, I got in the black there. You don't want to do that. Little dots. You notice I got some black in my pink dots. That's okay. If your brush seems to be making splat marks that you don't like, you can always take your brush and use the backside because it's nice and round. There's actually a tool that I don't have in my kit at the moment for the same effect. And just add polka dots. Polka dot the canvas. Get some of the other color in there, a little dark. A lot of dots to do. want to concentrate your dots towards the top of the tree, and then you can do the little wispy part down at a little angle, almost like a triangle in your mind. Down here, get that little triangle shape going. You can kind of see my triangle right there. I made an outline with polka dots. Here's your random falling little flowers. I want to do some larger dots, so I'm going to go back to this brush. You press on your brush, you're going to get splatters. You can get colors to mix and blend. It's going to create a different look. Just depends on what you're going for. No way is wrong. Cherry blossoms a little bigger, blend the colors more. So it's going to be a little more blurry, less polka dotty, almost like a weeping willow. Some dark ones towards the inside. Highlight with my pink. Basically, what I want my cherry blossom tree to look like, I'll add some fine lines and details to that. Looks like my favorite brush to do that has been stolen from one of my children, and that's okay. I'm going to go ahead and use this one instead. Get back in on that black action right there. And add little lines now. Finish that tree up. Now that you have a guideline, drag your roots in there. I'm just going to come to your base of your tree and drag your root. I got a V going on. Do a little X. Give it a little hand. He's got a hand sticking up in the air. My tree is growing weird. No tree has perfect roots. No tree grows perfectly straight, right? They all kind of do their own thing. They grow with nature. Thicken out these lines. Go right back over the same line you already had. Just in little spots. Just really kind of want your tree branch to... See, I made my question mark again. Add some... There, darken up that branch. Darken up maybe that one and this. See, I got a little Y going. Darken this. That's what I really like about painting. Is you can always change it as you go. If you don't like it, add something. Paint over it. This tree is an interpretation of your view. And so, I want to add some more black on my hill, because my hill is very light. So I'm going to add just some lines. Just basically I'm tracing the bottom of my hill where we had made it before. Add a little hump in the hill right here so my surface isn't flat. Color that in. I have a damp half-inch brush here. Kind of smooth that in to blend. Just kind of brush it down. Oops, put some white on there. Definitely didn't want to have white on there. It's okay. Just cover it up. See? It's a great thing about art. You can always cover up your mess. And there we have our nighttime cherry blossom. Thank you for painting with me. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask me. I'll be more than happy to help out. You guys have a wonderful day. Thank you again.